Ratnabhushan, welcome to SGIS Current Affairs. The editorial of today is ST Hindustan Times. It is today September 20, 2019. India needs a new social contract. India needs a new social contract. India needs a new social contract. The state must help citizens cope with the changes in technology, environment, and gender relations. This article was written by Minoos Shafiq. India is going through a time of the significant change, economic growth, technological advancement, and the closing gender gap, urbanization, the development of environment rights, environmental rights. All these factors are coming together to build India's role as a major world power. And while this development brings a new opportunity, times of transitions can be unsettling. The last decade has been a global rise in the populist politics fueled by insecurity in many countries, many blind globalization and nationalism, and I'm sure that they are part of the explanation, but I would argue they are second order issue. I think that the fundamental explanation lies in the pressures on a social contract, the balance between the rights and obligation of citizens. For example, social security, health care, and taxation, and our inability to adapt to this social contract to major economic, social, and environmental pressure. These pressures derive primarily from the technology, the changing role of the women, and the impact of climate change. The social contract has been failing in advanced economies for some time, leading to increasing discontent, even anger. People are angry because they feel they haven't benefited from the new developments and are at risk of being left behind. Routine workers are worried that technology will make their jobs obsolete. This in the rural areas of the disappropriate resources have gone to cities. Native population feel immigrants are changing their society. Men worry a new policy has quotas and target for women will disadvantage them. Older people feel the young are not grateful for their past sacrifices, and the young increasingly resent the elderly who consume a growing share of the resources while leaving them with a legacy of environmental destruction. The pressure leading to a division and the discontent can be managed if the social contract effectively provides people with insurance against the risk. For example, minimum pay when they are unemployed, opportunity to retrain, and the assurance they will get access to the good education, healthcare, and jobs. India has redefined its social contract in the past, meet changing needs with every Indian government, and putting reducing poverty and improving livelihood at the center of its agenda. The sustainable development goals provide international framework with the clear objectives, and to overcome successive governments have taken greater responsibility for the delivering aspect of the social contracts since independence. This was particularly the case in 1990s and 2000 is a series of the rights-based laws of the past by the four. National Rural Development, Employment, Education and Food Security. Initiatives such as the school meals, the Integrated Child Development Services, the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, MG Manrega, reach a significant proportion of the population, provide a minimum for a poor people incomes, as well as improve opportunity for children. Young children. Although these protections haven't come without their challenges, including uneven delivery of benefits, a problem with the corruption and delays in wage payments, there have been a real gains. For example, Manrega has generated about 2 billion days of work, 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 half done by women and more than half of scheduled caste or tribes, with the evidence of the gains in the reducing rural poverty. This development reflected rapid change as in incomes rose, urbanization occurred, and the site was increasingly called upon to deliver robust demands of the jobs, housing, education, and health care. As in advanced economies, further technological and social change, including the rise of the artificial intelligence, machine learning, and automation, will affect the stage of the evolution of the social contract in India. The country will once again need to be redefined its social contract to meet these new demands. And social people, through the inevitable changes, education will be a key building block in the navigating these changes. While there has been a considerable progress in education in India, especially in environment, enrollment in the primary and secondary levels, particularly for girls, and these, there will be a need to be a serious investment in reskilling, especially in the areas robots cannot do. An Indian social contract for the 21st century might also require a minimum income for all, the structured in a way of return incentives to work and retain. I would also argue better use should be be made of the growing pool of the female talent with more investment made the child care a shared parental leave and elderly care. The social contract in this India continues to rely heavily on the unpaid female labor. Despite the fact that the women are increasingly educated over time, the changes it has been many countries, more educated women will want to work out in the outside the home, not least because of economic rationale of the higher incomes will be very compelling. And noted in the analysis in the economics, if more women in India were supported to work in the paid labor market, India would be much richer. This is exciting time for India, and with a number of factors coming together, it is the opportune time for the countries to reassess its social contract. If their new contract support people through change and reassures them they will looked after during the inevitable dislocations that come with change, there will be no stopping India as it emerges on the world stage. Thank you so much to watch my program.